Let us begin. My first question. See, now I am presenting, so I could not see what is going on there in chat box. My first question is, I want the name of the element with atomic number 25.
Manganese.
Very good. Very good.
Manganese.
I want its electronic configuration. I help you. After argon means after 18 electrons. What is electronic configuration here? In
3D orbitals.
Yes. 4s2
3d5.
Right, 3d5. One hint I give it to you, except two elements, chromium and copper, all where number of d electrons, how many are here? 5. What is the last digit in atomic number? 5. And two electrons will be there in the s orbital. And number of electrons in d orbital equal to last digit in the atomic number. Yes. I want to know atomic number for Fe.
26.
So its electronic configuration, argon, of course, 18 electrons. Afterwards, help me.
4s2.
Yes.
3d6.
36.
Yes. Now see the logic that I told to you. 6 electrons in d orbitals and 6 is the last digit in the atomic number. And of course, s orbital will be with 2 electrons. Good. Third question. The element with atomic number 29 is?
Cuprum.
Yes. Cuprum. Or general way, we say it has what? Copper. Cu is its symbol. So its electronic configuration, of course, argon 18. Yes. Now tell me its electronic configuration.
4s1 3d10.
See, here usual rule is not applied. 4s1 3d10. So 10 cannot be the last digit, but 0, but here 9 is there. So copper is one kind of the exception. Copper and one more element I told you, exception for electronic configuration. What is that?
Chromium.
Along with copper, other element is there? Exception.
Chromium.
Exception to, yes?
Chromium.
Right. Chromium. Symbol?
Cr.
Cr. Chromium. So there, d orbital gets the some sufficient number of electron as per the stability, and then only one electron remains in the s orbital. So the fourth question I am asking, the element vanadium, what is the atomic number?
23.
Yes. Electronic configuration, of course, argon. After that,
4s2 3d3.
Logic is what? 3 electrons, 3 is the last digit. Only chromium and copper is an exception. Otherwise, 4s2 and electrons in d orbitals will be equal to the last digit of the atomic number. Okay. Now, the fifth question I am asking. The element chromium, atomic number?
24.
What is its electronic configuration? Argon, 18 electrons. Then?
4s1. 3d5.
3d5. Now main question. Up to here, everybody should understand. It's my expectation. And if still anybody could not cope up with this discussion, let me know about it. It's a very simple thing, but very, very important thing. Once you know the electronic configurations, then in their compounds, may it be the potassium dichromate. Potassium dichromate means K2Cr2O7. Potassium permanganate, KMnO4. Ferric oxide, Fe2O3, ferrous oxide, FeO, cupric chloride, CuCl2. There you will come to know the charges present on those element or the atoms. I'll come to that, finding the charge and the calculation of charge, importance of that charge calculation or oxidation state. My question here is, I want to know who can answer. Why for chromium this exception is there? Means in general way we are giving. It is not a very perfect answer, but let me know. Other where we are finding electrons in the d orbital are equal to the last digit. But for chromium and copper, we are finding next digit. Means for copper, 9 was there, next digit is 0. 0 means 10. 9, then 10 came. Digit not, but number came. For chromium, 4 is the last digit, 5 number came here. Why for chromium, where 3d5 is an electronic configuration, and for copper, where you already said the electronic configuration is 3d10. What is the speciality in this 3d5 and 3d10? Please help me. No one. See, there's a reason why chromium and copper show various, copper means cuprum, you can say, various oxygens, different than the others electronic configuration, in which only one electron is there in 4s orbital and 5 are there in d orbital, or 10 are there in d orbital. What is the magic in that number 5 and 10? What is the speciality of that number 5 and 10 for d orbital?
Because the d5 and d10 are more stable than d4 and 39.
Okay,
and it good. Stabilizes the symmetry, it stabilizes as well as it is a symmetrical distribution of electron density.
Yes, means 3D5 and 3D10 are stable electronic configurations. Likewise, I think Prathamesh is saying why these are stable. Means it's a general, it's not a perfect explanation. Why these are stable? Why 5 and 10? Why not 6? Why not 8? Something stability is there. Something specialization is there. One hint I give it to you. If I consider, say, F orbital, then for F orbital, F7 and F14, these are stable electronic configuration. For S orbital, 1 or 2. For P orbital, 3 or 6. For S orbital, 1 is not that much, but 2 is has given some stability. But here for P, partly applicable. For D and F, that concept is more applicable. So what you are finding similarity in 3 and 6 for P, 7 and 14 for F, and 5 and 10 for D. Yes, I had given hint to you.
Symmetrical
distribution. It is a half of electron.
Yes, yes. Symmetry in the sense what actually is not easy to understand, but symmetry is there. But now whoever has answered, no, half and fill. D orbital has capacity to accommodate 10 electrons. So 10 is a full stomach. 5 is 50%. Half P orbital, 6 full stomach. Full pill orbital, 3 half filled. F14 is full, 7 half filled. So half filled orbital and filled orbital, completely half filled orbital and completely full filled orbital govern extra stability. To make this concept clear, generally the example is given of the bus at the beginning, then the boat. Means suppose if all SOIBC students, means all groups, and they have the gathering or the trip is there, one bus came, then how will be the priority to choose that first seat? Generally not. Actually, old age person prefer first seat and the youths do prefer the last seat. This especially I observed in the bus. Reasons are there for that, but okay, they will capture the seats. But while capturing seats, what will the general nature, even in railway also we find window seat. So all window seat will be the first priority for the electrons or the students. And once all window seats are fulfilled, then there is no alternative. Pairing has to occur at somebody's neighboring place, you have to sit. So that's a general nature. Like an electron also, when they have to enter, and nearly same bus is same, no? It is not a different bus is there, other than at different time is there. At same time it is there. So orbital is same. So in spite of pairing at the beginning, that's a Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity, we say electrons will occupy all window seats first, and then the pairing of the electron takes place. And the status where all the window seats are captured, if I consider d orbital, first electron, second electron, third electron, fourth electron and fifth electron, these 5 electrons are there in the d orbitals, or actually d is a sub level. So this is what every orbital is equanimously filled. Equal number of electrons are there. It is not the fact that one orbital is more electron, other orbital is no. No, everywhere same load is there. Same number of electrons are there. So there is a symmetry. But if you can see the D10, then also every orbital, orbital in the sense CDX square minus Y square, DZ square, DXY, DYJ, DXZ, all orbitals will be with same number of electrons. Each orbital will be with 2 electrons. So it is what? Stable. So D10, D5, these are the stable electronic configurations. Students, are you understanding what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Oh, good. So D5 and D10 are the stable electronic configuration. It is a general. But yesterday I told you these explanations are prepared after electronic configuration, that actually how electron do enter in the atom. When if I talk about vanadium, then first 3D electrons do enter. First 3D electrons, 3 electrons, only 3 electrons. fourth electron, if has to enter in the d, it can enter actually. That much capacity is there of d orbital. 10 is the capacity of d orbital, but only 3 electrons to enter. Afterwards, that fourth electron finds that d orbital is not suitable, relatively suitable. More suitable is 4s. Afterwards, next fifth electron winner comes, means that 23rd electron comes, it also finds 4s orbital is suitable rather than 3d. Therefore, it is electronic configuration. This is the explanation as per true energy levels. In particularly that atom, we randomly or generally say 3d orbital is of one energy, 4s orbital of other energy. It is not absolutely true. Up to electronic configuration of calcium, that point has not came. Therefore, we are taken it granted. In true sense, when electron has to enter, then electron will see, every electron observes which is a suitable energy level. So yesterday I was saying, maybe that concept is not perfectly correct, clear to you, but since one day's pass, now you will easily understand. I think so. If not clear, then you can tell me. After 18, the 19th electron will go in 3D orbital, that I'm saying. 20th electron also will go in 3D orbital. 21st electron also will go in 3D orbital. Why? They are finding it is a low energy. And then 22nd electron is there, that goes in the 4s orbital. And last 23rd electron, I'm talking about vanadium, that goes in the 4s orbital. It is the electron building. So last electron is 23rd electron, and that is in 4s orbital. Second last electron is 22nd electron, that is in 4s orbital. If you have to remove these electrons, then this 23rd will be removed first, that's a 4s electron. Then 22nd electron will be removed first, that is also in the 4s orbital. Then 21st electron will be removed, that is in the 3d orbital. But anyhow, you are with the right final answer. Electronic configuration is this, but true reason, true explanation for electronic configuration that I was telling you. Students, I'm very happy to know you all. Very good. All have given the correct answers. But still few students are there. They are not talking. I am not here to only for the few students. I need to go toward the students. So next time I will ask randomly question to any student. And if you do not know, say do not know. Possibilities are there. You have not studied. But it is your responsibility that you have to study. So in advance, I will ask you whether you will prepare those things or not. So it's a good. So firstly, let us complete our the preparation that I asked you to do. That is the first transition series element and their atomic number or the electronic configuration about the few elements. Say the 5 to 6 we have discussed already. A few are left. Firstly, let me complete. Now I'll discuss only the atomic numbers, not the electronic configuration. You will understand how many electrons are there in the d orbital. That only the question. Ask. I want answer from you the atomic number of cobalt.
27.
Right. So in 3D orbital, how many electrons will be there?
Seven.
And 4s will be there too. And argon is what the usual electronic configuration. The element with atomic number 30 is
zinc.
Last element, and here complete filled d orbital. Complete filled s orbital. Speciality is there for the zinc. Okay. Element with atomic number 21.
Scandium.
Good. Electronic configuration. Okay, argon will complete. How many electrons are in d orbital?
One.
Good. Very good. See, purpose to ask that, if anybody has not prepared, at least we'll attempt to prepare that, because all are answering. And if anybody was not knowing the concept properly, now concept becomes what the mature. That was the intention. I told you, I'm doing some change in our methodology. This is a change that I'm doing. These things are very simple one. Now for the study, you have to grow. Yesterday only I took lecture, no? So today maybe possibly not read, but next time remember, considerable time is there. So what you have to prepare in this week means almost 5-6 days are there. The second transition series and third transition series elements and their atomic numbers you have to prepare. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now I want to go to the next concept.
Yes, sir.
That is the oxidation state, and then occurrence you will understand. So oxidation state means what? That fundamental concept I make clear. Listen very carefully. If you spend your next 15 minutes carefully, if you listen, you can get answers for many compounds questions, means the explanation for their oxidation state, their behavior, you will understand. We say, no, potassium permanganate. Answer for my question, potassium permanganate is oxidizing agent, reducing agent, potassium permanganate, potassium dichromate, oxidizing agents, reducing agents.
Oxidizing.
Now, you might have by-hearted that, or you might have went through the different reactions and you remember that. But why these are oxidizing agents, that concept will be clear if you know this now, the term and its application. That's a oxidation state. What that oxidation state concept is, oxidation state is a charge, formal charge, bearded by element in compound. Means if I say a simple compound H2 hydrogen, help me, what is the charge on hydrogen molecule? What charge you are finding here on H2?
No charge.
Zero charge.
Zero.
No, zero charge. So two hydrogen carries zero charge. Then one hydrogen will bear how much charge?
+1.
Yes, +1. Two hydrogen bear zero. Both have the same charge. It is not one has +1, other is -1. See, +1, whoever has said is by-hearted. I want the answer with simple calculation. Simple calculation I am asking to do. Simply ask
minus
the charge. Yes, what is the charge?
-1.
-1. Okay, one carries -1. Such two are there. Then total charge should be -2. So don't prepare your chemistry. I want simple application. You said no, H2 has zero charge. Because we are not represented. If charge would have been there, we have to represent the charge on the H2. Charge is not there, so zero. So two hydrogens carry zero charge. Simple. Simple mathematics. Then one hydrogen will carry how much charge?
Zero.
Yes, zero. Is it clear to all?
Yes, sir. Yes,
it
sir.
Is oxidation state of hydrogen. Charge bit. Zero also is a charge. Means charge means no charge is charge. Okay. Now H2O. What is the charge on H2O? New compound. Other compound I am taking. Water molecule has how much charge?
Zero.
Zero. Okay. So charge here is zero. Total charge is zero. But that zero is made from charge on two hydrogens plus charge on one oxygen. One oxygen. Here some knowledge of chemistry you have to apply. Oxygen and hydrogen, two elements are there. What your knowledge says, who is more electronegative?
Oxygen.
Right. So more electronegative means what will be its tendency? To take electron towards itself or to give electron? Not completely, partially. What are the bonds are there? No, that electron will be. In traveling also you find, no, few people remain. Tendency to occupy large seat means more space of the seat they will occupy. Physics is different. I'm talking about tendency. Means a person if thin, no, then also will keep other luggages and all and will feel as if like that he wants more space. It's a tendency. Likewise, elements also have tendency to take electrons out of sharing. So oxygen is more to negative. So who will have tendency to take electron towards itself? Oxygen or hydrogen?
Oxygen.
Oxygen. Yes. So because of that taking electron, oxygen will govern. Now, very simple question. Because of that extra electron, because of its tendency, oxygen will govern or bear which charge, positive or negative?
Negative.
Right. So oxygen is carrying negative charge. How much? That let us find. Or you also might be knowing that. On the other hand, hydrogen will bear positive charge. Because compared to oxygen, hydrogen is poor to take the electron towards itself. So it will give electron. But electron can be given, shared up to what extent? What are the properties there? That much can be given, no? Or electron can be taken to what extent? Till the stomach gets full, till stability is governed, till from general point of view, octet is completed. General chemistry I'm saying, not particular chemistry. So for both, we can have the similar dialogues. I need your help now. What's the property of hydrogen? How many electrons hydrogen remain?
Two.
No, only one atom I'm talking about. Now I'm talking about one hydrogen. Only one special hydrogen. So maximum it can give only one electron. No, miss it can. Whatever sharing is there, no? Maximum. So what is the charge? +1. So that now no electron. Till the octet completes or doublet completes that tendency. So hydrogen carries plus charge. Therefore, we say H+. By the way, hydrogen can take electron also. Hydrogen, its own property is one electron. How many electrons hydrogen can take? Because electrons are there in which orbital? 1s orbital electrons are there. One electron is there. Two possibilities are there. One possibility, this electron can be given to generate, to produce positive charge. And other possibility, how many electrons it can take? S orbital, how many electrons maximum possible?
Two.
So how many electrons maximum it can take?
One.
Because of that, it will be with which charge? If this thing happens, then charge will be
negative,
because it takes an electron. Listen carefully. If electron is taken, negative charge. But very good thing has happened. You are answering. Good thing. Let your answer be wrong. Don't worry about that. But you are learning now. Electron taken, negative charge. Electron given, positive charge. One electron can be given, one positive charge. One electron can be taken, one negative charge. So H plus and H minus, these are the possibilities. And that possibility depends upon neighbor. That possibility depends upon surrounding. Who is a neighbor here in the water? Oxygen, more electronegative. So oxygen will not allow to take hydrogen, the electron needed. Then there's only option available towards the hydrogen to give the electron. So H plus will be the result. H plus. Are you understanding, students, what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now what about the oxygen? Oxygen has atomic number 8. So its electronic configuration, helium is over. Two electrons are there in helium. After that two electrons, the electron enters in 2s orbital. That's a two electrons. And in 2p orbital, there are four electrons. So p orbital, p sublevel, three orbitals are there. First, second, third, and fourth. So here you are finding gap. Along with this, one electron can arrange. Here also one electron can arrange. So here these two gaps are there. Those two gaps can be filled by electrons. One electron and second electron. So if that oxygen takes those two electrons, so that octet will be completed. Two electrons plus four plus taken two electron. So total octet will complete. So oxygen is taking two electrons. Therefore, it has negative charge. So how much negative charge will be there on oxygen? O. How much negative? How many electrons are taken? How many electrons is the need? Number I want now here.
Two.
Yes, minus two. Oxygen minus two. So what is minus two? Oxidation state. What is plus one? Oxidation state of hydrogen here and previously oxygen. Similarly, if I talk about the other compound, say HCl, I need your help now. What may be the charge on hydrogen here? What is the charge on chlorine? By your common logic, hydrogen is only one electron, so either it can give one electron or it can take one electron. Chlorine also is electronegative like oxygen. Now, what is the option in front of hydrogen?
Plus one.
Right, plus one will be the charge on the hydrogen. If plus one is the charge on hydrogen, total charge on HCl is zero, plus one is the charge on hydrogen, then how much charge will be there on the chlorine?
Minus one.
Right, minus one. So what is this plus one? Oxidation state of hydrogen. What is this minus one? Oxidation state of the chlorine. Similarly, if I take example CuCl2, then few elements are there. They are with some behavior, some oxidation state fixed one. It's common sense also we have to apply there. Oxygen, if it is there, then will carry minus two charge. If any halide is there, will carry minus one charge. General point of view. If any first group element is there, potassium K plus, sodium Na plus, lithium Li plus. If any second group element is there, beryllium plus two, calcium plus two, magnesium plus two. This is general, preferably, and it depends with whom they are what combining. Hydrogen generally shows plus one because neighboring elements remains more to negative, but it can show minus on oxygen state also. It depends. So basic idea regarding electronegativity, with whom that element is going to combine, will it give electron or will take electron, and depending upon number of electrons, their charges will be there. Here they have only one electron, so first group element plus one charge. Here they have the two electrons, s orbital, therefore they have the plus two charge. Here they need only one electron, therefore they have the minus one charge. Here oxide, sulfide, they need two electrons, therefore they have the minus two charge. If I say nitride, then there will be the minus three charge. If I say aluminium, plus three charge will be there. So depending upon electronic configuration, their charges remain. So few elements, their charge behavior is fixed. And for a few, it is a variable. Especially for the elements which we are discussing, those are the transition series elements, their charge variability showing is too much. Therefore, while finding their oxidation state, we have to rely on other elements. We have to rely on the basic of other. So if the question comes to you, what is the oxidation state of copper? in this copper or this CuCl2, or you can say cuprum. Cuprum is what the element. Now here it is what the ion. So Cu ion, what will be the charge on that? Then basic, what you should be with, I give explanation. After those remaining examples, you have to answer. Basic, I will ask, do I know the charge on the chlorine? Then I will say yes, 17 group element. So it will tend to take electron. So charge is what? -1. So chlorine carries -1 charge. Such two chlorines are there. And copper carries which charge? So that there will be the zero charge on the molecule, because CuCl2 carries no charge. Yes. Will anybody answer what the charge on the copper? Just solve this mathematics. Zero plus two. So oxidation state of copper is +2. So students, what I told to you now, oxidation state is a charge bear by the element in a compound. Various examples that I discuss. For that few elements, their oxidation state should be clear to you. If they are the first group element, the charge will be +1. Generally, I am saying. If it's a second group element, charge will be the +2. For example, for this, you can give, say, sodium ion, Na+. For example, for this, say, calcium. If it's a 17th group element, then charge will be the -1. What is the example for this? Chloride or fluoride or iodide. If the 16th group element, then generally charge will be the -2. Example is oxide, O-2. It's a basic. With this, we can find out the charges on the various ions. Up to here, concept clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes.
Yes,
sir. Now I am asking here further 5 questions to you. Means we are applying our concept. Memorization is one thing, and students will enjoy that application. If you know that, and because of that, your concept also will grow. Only by adding relation doesn't remain. No, concept, application, relation remain there. So examples which I had considered: K2Cr2O7, KMnO4, Cr2O3, Fe2O3, and one interesting example, NiCl4-2. I want oxidation state of each transition. Here chromium is a transition series element. Here manganese is a transition series element. Here chromium is a transition series element. Here Fe, ferrum or iron is a transition series element. Here nickel is a transition series element. Now we have to do calculation. First calculation, with your help, I will complete. One by one, I have to discuss. Say for potassium, two potassiums are there. What is the charge on potassium that you have to answer?
+1.
Yes, yes. Good, good. I'm coming there. Two chromiums are there. What is the charge on the chromium? That is our last finding. ? Then two oxygens are there. Sorry. 7 oxygens are there. What is the charge on oxygen? That is the answer. And total charge is 0. It's a simple mathematics. I need to find ? Now, we have to fill the blanks. What is the charge on potassium? Help me now.
+1.
What is the charge on oxygen?
-2.
Yes.
Solve
this and give me the answer for ? Brilliant.
+6.
At least one more answer. Good. So +6 is the oxidation state of chromium. Will it be clear to everyone? I am not showing that mathematical calculation. I hope you will understand. If not there, you work at your own. You will understand. Even if not clear, you can ask next time. We will have the discussion. I hope that time will not come to discuss. Okay. Now let me come to the second. One potassium is there. It has one charge. One manganese is there. What is the charge on that? That I have to find out. 4 oxygens are there. Charge on oxygen. Yes. What is the charge on potassium?
+1.
Charge
+1.
On oxygen?
-2.
Yes. Now tell me, what is the ? Answer for the question.
+7.
Very good. All you are brilliant. Yes. You understood the concept of oxidation state. But still 3 examples are there. Next is Cr2O3. 2 chromiums are there, and charge on chromium I have to find out. It's a ? 3 oxygens are there. Yes, help me. What's the charge on oxygen generally?
-2.
Yes, then tell me the answer for this ?
+3.
Very good. So chromium is in. See, here chromium is in +6. Here it is in +3. Okay. Now come to the next. That is Fe2O3. 2 irons are there. Charge on 1 iron. I don't know. I have to find out. 3 oxygens are there. Charge on each oxygen?
-2.
Yes. Then what's the ?
+3. +3.
Yes, it is a Fe plus 3 ferric ion that generally we say. Ferric, ic means higher oxygen state. Ferrous also possible, low oxidation state. Yes. Now, can anybody answer for last question? Charge on nickel. Yes. What's the answer?
Plus 2.
Plus 2.
Very good.
Plus 2.
Very good, very good, very good. Brilliant. I'm happy to know you all. Very good. One nickel is there. Charge we do not know. Four chlorides are there. We know the charge. And final charge is there, not zero here. Here minus 2. Here see, minus 2. And with that, you could get the answer. Nickel carries the plus 2 charge. So now I hope and expect that concept of oxidation state and of finding the oxidation state is clear to you. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes. Now come to our transition series elements. These transition series elements, the speciality, the point number one, they show variable oxidation state. Means one time chromium is in plus 6, one time chromium is in plus 3, other time chromium will be in the plus 4, iron in plus 3, plus 2, other oxidation state, copper plus 1, plus 2. So variable oxidation states are shown by these transition series elements. What is that exact variation? Which oxidation states are shown? That we have to discuss. I'll come to that. But let you know why they show that variable oxidation state. For that, what is that oxidation state concept? If clear, then why will be the clear? If why is clear, then explanation will be the clear to you. So let me go one by one. I told you, what is oxidation state? It's a charge bearded by the element in a compound. So in compound, what happens? That element surrounds by means of the other atoms or ions. And everybody has different tendency to take or give electron. If electrons are given, positive charge will be there on that element. If electrons are taken, the negative charge will be there on that element. Yes, students, are you getting point what I'm saying?
Repeat one time.
Yeah. I'll repeat. What is oxidation state? It is a charge bearded by the element in a compound. Various examples that we have discussed, NaCl for minus 2, Cr2O3. They're everywhere we found the charge on the transition series atom. So that charge is the oxidation state. Up to here, clear?
Yes.
That charge can be positive when? If electrons are given or taken?
Given.
Means really electropositive. And charge will be of course negative if electrons are taken. It's a basic. That only I told. Now important point. Listen carefully. Only last means few seconds are there. You have to listen this point. That electrons whichever are there in transition series elements, they are in the 3D and 4S orbitals. They are good neighbors. They are good friends. Their energy levels are comparable. They are nearby only. Means nearby locality only they are staying. Because of that nearby locality, so tendency to go that all can, because these are metals now, they can show the electropositive nature. So electron can go from 4S as well as 3D. Too much difference is not there in moving the electron. If I consider, say, nitrogen, atomic number is 7, its electronic configuration, that's a 2s2 and 2p3, removal of electron in p orbital, actually it's electron negative, but even if I consider removal of electron in 2s orbital, too much gap is there in the energy gap. But here, removal of electron from 4s, and removal of electron from 3D, similar energy gap is there. Not that much difference is there. Because of that, this transition series element show the tendency to involve the electrons from 4S and 3D. That is rare in other elements. If I take the example of, say, sodium, one more example, atomic number 11, electronic configuration, after neon, 3S, only one electron is there. So before 3S, 2P electrons are there. But energy needed for 3S and energy needed for 2P, lot of gap is there. Too much difference is there. That difference is not in these transition series. So what is the conclusion? The electrons about which we are talking, electrons, those we need to remove. Electrons because of which these elements show electropositive nature or they show positive charge. Those electrons do exist in which orbitals? 3D and 4S. And energies of 3D and 4S are comparable, and due to which large number of electron can be available or variations are there depending upon the neighbor. Means if demand is there for 2 electron, they are ready to give 2 electron. If demand is there for 3 electron, they can give 3 electron also, 4 electrons also, 5 electrons also, if electrons are available. So manganese is a best example which shows plus 2 oxidation state also and plus 1 oxidation state also. It can give 2 electrons also, it can give 7 electrons also. What kind of variation it is? So Mn plus 2 to Mn plus 7, that's a variation. So this variation is because energy of 3D and 4S is comparable. Their energies are comparable or nearby. So large variety of electrons are involved. To make this concept clear, I give you the one example. Say you are in the classroom. SIBC chemistry students are there in classroom. And Roderick sir, for some kind of the task, say, is need of the 4 volunteers. Example I'm giving. And SIBC classroom is nearby. FIBC classroom is at other floor. Then 4 volunteers, from where will be, from which classroom will be taken? From SIBC only will be taken, because they are very nearby. Easily they can be accessible. But suppose if classrooms are nearby only, then 2 from FY, 2 from SY also can come. Or more than 4 also if required over there, then first SY, then FY students also can be taken. And if too much gap is there, or few, one classroom is in Kura High School and one is in Kura College, too much gap is there, then whatever are there here available in college, with them work will be get done. So that is a case where one is in Kura High School and other is in Kura College. Too much gap is there in the energies. But here, gap is not more, very nearby. And because of that, variable oxidation states are shown by these transition series elements. I repeat, oxidation state means is a charge bearing by the element in a compound. It can be positive if electrons are given, negative if electrons are taken. It depends on electronegativity. It is found that transition series elements show the variable oxidation state. Reason is, electrons about which we are talking, they are in 3D and 4S orbitals. And how are those 3D and 4S orbitals? Their energies are comparable nearby. And therefore, they show variable oxygen state. What's the example for that? Mn plus 2 to Mn plus 7. Such many examples are there. In particularly, we are discussing those all examples. But let me know, is this point clear to you? No, if no, then tell me what. I'll repeat. What is not clear? Tell me what happens. Not clear? What exactly not clear? No, in which... what shall I answer, what portion, or shall I answer why portion, or shall I answer both portions? No, please reply within few minutes. I will explain that all.
Both.
Only one reply upon. Okay.
Both.
Okay. I give example. Both. Okay. Fine. Lastly, within 2 minutes I am explaining. So pay attention for this 2 minutes. If I take example of MnCl2, manganese carries plus 2 charge, and if I take example of KMnO4, manganese carries plus 7 charge. Such many other compounds are there in between also. So manganese shows oxidation state from plus 2 to plus 7. That's a variability. Therefore, my point was the transition series elements show variable oxidation state. It is our point. So what is oxidation state? It is a charge bearing by the element in a compound. So plus 2 is a charge and plus 7 is a charge. So up to here, I think it is clear to you. If not, then again, you can ask me. Then question arises, why they show variable oxidation state? The reason, listen carefully. Reason is the outermost electrons are in a 3D and 4S orbitals. And 3D and 4S for namesake different orbitals, but their energies are same. And because of same energies, wide variation in the removal of electron is possible. If I take example for manganese, say 5 electrons are in D orbital and 2 are there in S orbital. So this 2 electron and this 5 electron, total 7 electrons are there towards manganese, which can be given. Depending upon the surrounding, electrons will be given. If chloride comes, it will give 2 electrons. If oxide comes, it can give 7 electrons, and in between also variable oxidation states are there. So that's a variation. And it is because the energy gaps are comparable. Energy gaps are nearby. Therefore, I'd give an example. One class is in college, other class is in high school. This location you consider. So gap is there. Then whoever are then called nearby, the work will be get done. If all are there nearby, then all will be involved in what the one kind of the task. So variable oxygen state are there because energies are comparable. Is it clear now or still not?
Clear.
And still if it's not clear, only one answer is there. Other?
Clear.
Yes, sir. Understand.
Go through the video. It will take time to upload that. And after, once you go through, and again, if not clear, I am there. See, till each student understand, I am here to explain. I will never say, why are you asking repeatedly? But you have to ask student. If you do not ask, I will not. Now, one student or two students have said, nothing is clear. Both have to answer. It's a good honesty it is. But whoever I answered now, previously answered, no, both have to explain. For them, at least partly clear 50%. Don't expect that concept. Concept also digestion takes place slowly. Whatever we learn today, no, tomorrow gets perfectness. Tomorrow gets, you get less time. Automatically it happens. It's so programming. And that programming you have to boost. Yes, whoever answered that, both have to explain. Is it clear now, at least partly?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, students. So, shall we stop now?
Yes, sir.